Hello and welcome back to my garage. Today my brother's car is back in the shop. His left, well in this case the left side, because well we drive on the right, so the driver is in on the left in the car. So otherwise it will be the other way around. The left side caliper is sticking, and a while ago, I believe last year somewhere, I already make it, well, that it moves again. It is the e-brake / parking brake lever that is, seized up in the system. My goal was to repair... Stupid chicken. My goal was to repair the caliper or refurbish it. But instead I chose to, replace it all. This is just a refurbished unit. Most of the time it is a return system. So you take off your old one and put it back in the box. And then of course you bring it back to the shop and then you get your, how do you call it? We call it statiegeld. A deposit. Well, at least that's what Google says. Most of the time you have to pay a deposit for, well, when you buy a refurbished part, so, and when you bring it back or bring the old part back, then you get your deposit back. In this case, you don't have to. So this is from Metzger. I did use their parts. I do believe they make more than only brake parts, but I don't use them very often. But I didn't have any problems with that. So instead of repairing the caliper, we're going to play the part swap boy and we'll replace only this thing. So, but that's enough said. It should not be that hard of a deal. The only thing we definitely need to do is bleed the brakes after we're done. So let's get this thing on the car. This is the best shot I can make. Right here is the post of the lift. So I don't have much room to maneuver the camera around. So we don't have to remove the whole cradle or the saddle, but we need to remove, of course, the caliper. But before that, we're going to remove the feed line, or well, the brake line, and of course the e-brake itself, because we're going to open up the brake system. It's going to leak. By itself, it isn't that big of a problem. The only thing is, of course, there are some ways to prevent it. And one is, of course, pinch the rubber hose. But in this case, this isn't a rubber hose. Yeah, it's a rubber on the outside, but it's not a traditional rubber hose. This is a braided line and, of course, encapsulated in rubber. We're definitely not able to pinch this without destroying this thing. So that's not an option. Another option is you have special clamps that if you remove this, then you can put it into the line, and that will prevent leaking. I don't have those things, so that's for me also not an option. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply force on the brakes. Press the brake pedal. Because if it is pressed, at least the master cylinder doesn't want to drain, and hopefully the vacuum of the fluid in the system. The tool now is in its place, and as you can see, it's not going anywhere. The only thing is, of course, if we're going to loosen this, it's definitely going to spray some fluid out of there. That is just something we just cannot stop happening. So get your wife's favorite pajamas and put it underneath it. I always use a brake line spanner for stuff like this. It just helps avoiding rounding off these things. If they're really, really stuck, then I'm going to get a vice grip, but I don't expect it. But it's dead stuck. But it does one stupid thing, and that is rotating the line. Hopefully you can see that. It looks like it is C-step. The other thing what could be happening is because of the oil pressure that is now building in the system. And because of that old oil pressure, well, everything locks up, of course. So instead of forcing it loose now, I'm going to undo my tool that's holding in the brake pedal. Try if I get it loose then. I definitely not want to ruin this fitting. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave it as it is now and remove the caliper and then twist the caliper around. So right back here, you probably just cannot see it, but that is the emergency brake cable. And because it's stuck, or the lever is stuck, hopefully we can just pull the cable out like this. And then you can undo it. If not, press it in with a screwdriver and then take it out of there. Next up, these two bolts here, and these are 13. The inside is now spinning right here. And if that happens, just put a spanner on it. In this case, it's a 15. And of course, we do the same for the top side. So, like I said, I'm now going to twist the brake caliper off. Well, there is going to be some pressure loss, so that's why I'm putting the rack around it. It isn't much, but it is there. So hopefully I can get this loose. If not, then we have to do the same thing while mounting. Yeah, it's definitely stuck. So I probably have to mount the new caliper on the same way I removed this one. Well, there is a plug right here. Obviously, you have to remove that one. And let's twist it on again. And of course, it's totally in the wrong place. To be honest, I did think that it would happen. Sometimes you're lucky, sometimes you ain't, and today is one of those ain't things. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to heat it up. Of course, the plastic coating will melt, so we have to recoat it with some paint later. Of course, I could have done that when I wanted to remove it, but I'd rather not damage these coatings. Well, this cools down, we're going to put back the caliper. First thing what I'm going to do is clean up the brake dust that's collected on the pads itself. Also, going to check if the slide pins are still working fine, and they definitely do. And these glide things, I'm going to just a little bit of grease. You don't suppose to grease these things, at least. But call me old-fashioned, I like to grease those things. Not with a lot, just with a little bit. As you can see, the thing is still not dripping. Most of the time what I do is also a little bit on these springs. You don't have to, but like I said before, I'm maybe a bit old-fashioned. Next up the handbrake, going to be probably a bit harder to get it on now. But like I said, most of the time just with a push with a screwdriver. Be sure that you don't stab yourself. I have a habit of doing that. Hopefully it's not stuck again. Well, it was a bit stuck. It does turn fine now. Let's put this one back in its place. And because we need to bleed the brakes, I'm going to crack the bleeder nut. And now of course I'm going to remove the pedal tool and let gravity do its work for a while. So next up, what I'm going to do is monitor the fluid level in the master cylinder. Most of the time what I'm doing is just a piece of hose. I'm crack of course the bleeder valve, and as you can see, it's already, the fluid is already coming right here. And now the only thing you have to do is just pump the brakes until there is no air in there anymore. You don't have to open close the bleeder valve. You don't have to do that. You can do this by yourself. But what I'm always doing is making a loop, so there is always pressure on, or at least there is always fluid available to suck back into the system. Because you are going to see, if I'm going to press the pedal, the fluid will come up. And when I release the pedal, it's going back a little bit. It's going up, it's going back a little bit, it's going up, it's going back. So what you want is, well, at least that there is fluid going back. And of course, we're doing a loop. First of all, the pressure of the fluid, so that the fluid isn't and the second of course is that the air bubbles will always rise to the top, so the air bubbles will come out. Well, we now pumped it a couple of times, but always be sure that you have enough fluid in the reservoir. So don't pump too much. I do think everything is now out of the system. I also flushed the system. I'm going to do it on all four of the wheels. Principle is the same. Just be careful with those bleeder valves. They can be really stuck in there, and yes, you can snap them off. So heat is then definitely your friend. Just wiggle those things a little bit around so that you definitely know there's nothing stuck in the frets. So, but be careful with those. Those can definitely break off. If they do snap off, what I have done in the past is just undo the brake line or the brake nut. So then you're going to bleed through there. The only problem is then this method with the hose doesn't work. Then you definitely need a mate or your mother-in-law that's helping well pump the brakes for you. Don't forget, of course, the rubber grommet that goes on the nipple itself. As you can see, the caliper is still flopping around even when we bleed the brakes. What we need to do is apply the handbrake for a couple of times. Just to pump the brakes a couple of times, and of course the handbrake, and now it's nice and tight. It's normal that it's dragging like this, so if it's really stuck, yeah, well then you have to maybe clean up the pads a little bit more, but this is fine. And that is how you replace your rear caliper on, in this case, a Renault Megane. It isn't that difficult. There aren't that many hurdles to overcome. The only thing you definitely want to do is, of course, bleed your brakes. But also, yeah, that isn't that complicated to do. You can do it so the method I use, just with a hose and pushing the pedal. And after all the air is gone, then of course close the bleeder valve. This is probably the most complicated thing you have to keep in mind when replacing one of your calipers, and that's for all the calipers on every car. Other than that, yeah, be careful with those bleeder valves. They can snap, like I said before. So be sure that you don't do that. I know it's easy said than done, but just be careful. And if you think that the thing is really stuck in there, then it's probably indeed really stuck there. So apply some heat. Most of the time they will come loose very easy. But yeah, that's something you have to deal with. Of course, I use that fancy tool for pushing in the brakes, but you definitely don't need that. Just something, just maybe even a brick, if you put it on the brake, that's probably enough. It really helps keep in the oil, as you have seen. So yeah, that's it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it, or at least learned something from it. If you did, please give the like. If you want to follow me around, you know what to do, and I will see you next time. Bye.